So here we are in Maya's weight painting tool, found under skin, and then we can go paint weights tool. When we are in this tool, we have this panel here, which you see can be expanded and contracted. And of course, there's a reset button. We have order of sorting. We have the ability to isolate individuals by name. We can type in the name or even use wildcards to isolate a group. I'm gonna isolate an individual, 21 here. And that just works. I can also isolate things by selecting either by doing a shift select, so select one, shift select the entire set, or by going through and control clicking individuals and then pinning them. This, of course, when you have very large hierarchies, you can go ahead and quickly access the joints that you need to paint with rather than scrolling up and down a list. I'm just going to unpin that and just select an individual. I can also select individuals aside from using this method by going ahead and right-clicking and dragging north. This will quickly select those guys in a more interactive way. Selecting in here, if you've chosen to pin and get them all isolated there, can be great here, but it's also nice to be able to quickly select them in the viewport. In Softimage, this of course is using the middle click, whereas here we're just getting used to holding down the right mouse button and dragging north. If I scroll down a bit, you can see paint select, and geometry. And if I click on the model itself, I also have the ability to change between paint mode, object mode, select mode, paint select mode, etc. As well as the option of clicking on the joints and picking some of these things like the lock influences that are up in here, etc. These lock elements, when clicked on, will prevent that joint from receiving new weighting values. And of course, we have the color associated to it, so we have an index. This index will alter the color when in multicolored feedback. I'll show that in a moment. And we have an RGB, which doesn't alter the multicolor feedback in terms of the weight painting, but will change the color of the joint itself. So you can pick manually a color, but again, that won't affect the painting's colors. We have the ability to go to replace, add, scale, and smooth, which are different sort of painting modes. Replace is the absolute mode in Softimage. Smooth, pretty much the same, additive mode, we've got that. Scale is a little bit awkward one to describe. It's available in the tool help, and it gives an interesting explanation. It's not something that I use fairly frequently myself, so have a look at it. We have our profile of our brush, be it very hard, medium hard, which is the default, and then very smooth. We have the option for skin weight. Skin weight, of course, is the association from the vertex to the joint itself. And then, of course, we have DQ blend. And I'm very sorry, this has nothing to do with ice cream. It has everything to do with dual quaternion, which is the method of deformation that maintains volume a little bit better. And when you switch into that mode, it says where you're painting a value that it does the dual quaternion, and where there is no value, it's doing the classic linear method. Then we have, of course, our normalization, which we've discussed before. All of those are available there. We have our opacity value and a min and max value, as well as a flood and an eyedropper to pick a selection from there, from directly on the surface. So if I were to eyedrop that, you can see the value has been selected, and I drop that, wink, and I get a full value. My preference when going and working in here is, as a working mode, I will typically select via right click for the selecting the influence, and I will go between my selection modes here using select, paint select, and select geometry directly from here. I'm just finding this a little bit faster than right clicking and going through here. Another factor that you really should be aware of is when you're in object mode, we have to deal with selection hierarchy. Selection hierarchy has locators, aka nulls, joints, and curves before geometry, which means if I go into a selection mode and I go and drag across, it's going to highlight the joints first, which is a little bit annoying. So the second that you come into this panel, you should probably just click up here or press F8 to switch into a pure component mode so that you can start working with this in a way that is more beneficial, where you can go ahead and drag across and not be affected by selection hierarchy. So as you can see, I can switch very quickly between grabbing a selection, going into paint mode, hitting flood, or using the weight hammer, and then I can go back and select the geometry and go back into full painting mode. Because when you have a selection active, of course, it isolates that section, just as it would in Softimage. So some similarities there. We have a gradient view that we can utilize. And when I click on that, it shows very small values. If I were to just fudge this for a second here, I'm going to go to a really small value, 0.1. It's actually not super small, it's 10%. But so I paint across here in replace mode, which is, again, my absolute. It's gone ahead and painted that. I've added a value, a pure value, and yet we're not really seeing it in this black and white mode. It's really not that visible. If I go ahead and switch to the use color ramp, you'll see it's very clear that 10% is there. So working in black and white mode, you can actually miss some things if you're not careful. Using this really makes it obvious where black is pure zero and white is pure 100% the value of the weight. So the blue is a really small value, and it's really easy to see. Great for diagnosing. This is where I would go in, and typically speaking, at the starting of this process, I would use the Prune Small Weights feature. So Prune Small Weights option box. I've already got it set to about 10%, although it's usually 1% is the default value. And I'll just go ahead and prune that, and you'll see that it's pruned down some of the very small weights. There's a few left over. I could go a little bit higher and get rid of those. We have a radius, which is controlled here, although this tweaking this is really difficult between 0 and 1. It actually goes to a rather large number to deal with large-scale rigs. But if I hold down B, and then drag with my left mouse button in and out, you can see that I will change my brush size right there, which you'll see update right here. We can use a screen projection mode, but it basically makes the icon for your, or the view of your brush go away. Then we have stamp spacing, just like in most paint programs and sculpting programs. We have stylus pressure control. If you're using a tablet, as I am, you can turn that on and off, and also determine whether you want it to work with opacity, radius, or both. You have the ability of adjusting things like the wireframe. If you have a very dense mesh, you can turn on and off that wireframe and make it a little bit easier to see at different distances while you're doing broad strokes and painting, where the mesh itself may prevent you from seeing the actual weighting. We also have the multicolor feedback, a la Softimage. And of course, when you're working with a different selection, you see the highlighting become stronger in that area. And as I promised, when you're up here changing the colors of these guys, this guy is set to blue. Click him, and I'll change to yellow. Apply. You'll see it changed to yellow. However, if I use the RGB and click on this guy and go, let's say, purple, apply, you notice nothing seems to have happened until I leave this tool, and you can see that the joint itself has changed purple, but not the actual painting. Let's go back into that tool. And we also have our x-ray joints option. We can turn on and off if those are getting in your way, and you can play with that. So once again, selecting method, I usually use right click north. It just is nice and quick. I just gesture upwards, don't even see the interface, and it quickly grabs those things that I want. And then for moving back and forth between selecting vertices and so on, I make sure that I turn this guy on first and then switch as I will to go ahead and select these things that I want, and then go back into paint mode, flood those things, or go back into geometry and do some proper painting. Last but not least, of course, is if I go into select some of these guys and go into Window, General Editors, Component Editor, you can go directly into the Smooth Skin panel, and the Smooth Skin will show you all the weighting values for currently selected vertices, so you can quickly adjust these guys. Simply by clicking on one and shift clicking on another one, it will grab the entire group, or you can control click your way through and pick multiples. And then of course typing a single value will change all of them simultaneously. We have a total at the end here to let us know when we're in a normalization mode whether or not it's actually going to a value of one, or if it's sitting below a value of one, and that will give us all that. So that's the gist of weight painting, so the very basic tour, and hopefully that was useful.